My name is Greg Cox. I'm an assistant teaching professor in the Department of Health Sciences and the Department of Physical Therapy, and then I'm also a licensed physical therapist. Physical therapists are movement experts, and that can look a lot of different ways depending on the patients that you're working with. Primarily, physical therapists are focused on movement and function in their patients. And for some patients, that's working on mobility and basic mobility and walking. For other patients, it could be something like, you know, working on throwing and really high level activities with athletes. But primarily, you're focusing on the mobility that is important to patients. And a lot of times, it's regaining that function that a patient may have lost, or trying to maximize the function for a patient to achieve a higher level. Clinical careers is where graduates are going, where physical therapy graduates are going. But within that, there are really a number of paths that clinicians can follow. They can work in an orthopedic setting, which is a little bit more bones, joints, you know, backs, ankles. They can go into neurological care, which is strokes and brain injuries and patients who have been diagnosed with Parkinson's disease or multiple sclerosis. They can work in a pediatric setting. They can work geriatrics with older adults. Physical therapists can work in an acute setting in the hospital or a skilled nursing facility. They can work with athletes. They can work in home health. And so it's really broad and really diverse. And I think oftentimes students are surprised by just how broad and diverse the profession is in terms of professional pathways that they can follow after graduation. Physical therapy is unique. It's a unique niche in that we have opportunities to spend time with our patients. Oftentimes we're seeing patients for 45 minutes at a time, and that's somewhat unique in healthcare. And so that provides an opportunity to really talk to patients, to make sure they understand their condition, to make sure they understand how to best manage this diagnosis and what their prognosis looks like. And so it's just a great opportunity to, again, earn that trust and educate patients in a meaningful way. My best advice is to observe as many settings as you can and get into as many settings as possible, because it is a really diverse field professionally. And so, you know, as you're considering the profession, as you consider making really a significant commitment to the profession, it's important that you really understand all of the settings you could work in, and it helps provide an opportunity to really see what's out there and strike that student's interest.